remember when I was 6 years old. I live in Canton, Ohio, and you can always find me playing with my two best friends. Those were the fun times. We would have sleepovers, go out to McDonald's every week, and this is the great part, we would have almost no homework to worry about. But more importantly, we were always there for each other. If I got a new toy, I would share it with them. If they got a cupcake from the school fair, they would get me one too. Talking with them was effortless, and the flow of words, thoughts, and ideas between us was endless. Fast forward to 2019. After having been in California for 8 years, I still haven't felt that connection to someone that I felt with my best friends in kindergarten. I realized here that there is a disconnect. We have friends, but are we really true friends? In today's society, everyone seems increasingly secretive. The connection with our peers is limited, and competition comes to the forefront. We develop a fear that others may get better opportunities than us if we disclose ours. And we feel insecure sharing even our happiest moments with our closest friends. We don't tell anyone about internship opportunities, extracurriculars, or leadership positions we may have, nor do we want to talk about our academic scores. This really made me feel, what has our society come to? Where did those innocent, carefree days go when nothing stopped us from saying what was on our mind? The once bubbly and effervescent kids we're now constantly worried that somebody may be better off than us. Me being the outgoing and inevitably chattery person that I am, it became really hard to connect with others on a deeper level if we both couldn't open up to each other. We seem to put ourselves in a bubble, always afraid that if that bubble bursts, our true self will be revealed and known to all. Concealing ourselves only makes us feel more isolated and actually leads to loneliness. But what is loneliness? Let me explain. Loneliness doesn't necessarily mean that one is physically alone. Instead, it can mean that one feels alone or alienated even when others are around. It's when you create the sort of facade of happiness at school, but when you come home, you feel quite empty inside. And according to a 2018 report by Douglas Nemseth, a chief medical officer at Cigna, loneliness actually has the same effect on mortality as smoking 15 cigarettes a day. And you see, loneliness can not only make us feel more sad and secluded inside, but also plays with our minds and decreases our sense of self-worth that everybody deserves to hold high. Where did those days go when no one cared if you carried a SpongeBob, Dora, or Scooby-Doo backpack, when everybody wanted to be called on by the teacher, even if we didn't know the answer? And when we could run around freely, playing tag with one another, even if we didn't know each other because we were all friends. As we grow older, we become more and more self-conscious and reluctant to take pride in who we are. I myself have felt insecure about my height and doubted my capabilities at times. Amidst these thoughts, I remember reading a graduating senior's note to her freshman self on the Bullseye, our school newspaper, during my freshman year in high school. Her note was centered around how, after 4 years of school, she still felt like a mediocre student, just one amongst everybody else, with nothing special or unique about her. However, the one thing I couldn't believe was that she had so many amazing talents that she just didn't recognize. Her writing skills were unparalleled, and all her articles seemed so cohesive and relatable. Yet, she just didn't acknowledge her knack for it. Remember how in kindergarten, we were chosen to be Superstar of the Week, and we had to make a poster about the things we were good at, the things we liked to do, our favorite color, and more? Don't let that superstar feeling leave you. Learn to appreciate yourself and embrace your talents, because you are whole, you are enough, and you matter. Dwelling into this never-ending hole of loneliness only makes us feel useless and mediocre. But no one should feel that way. Clearly, we all beat ourselves up one too many times for not being good enough. But sometimes, all we need to do is look at ourselves through a different lens and give ourselves a pat on the back. Removing ourselves from this feeling of loneliness means not only learning to be more self-confident, but also finding the right friend group, which embodies our authenticity and makes us feel happy. You see, our whole concept of friendship itself can be enhanced if we just take a step back from all this competition, take a deep breath, and remember those simple kindergarten times when we tried to match stuffed animals or when we willingly helped our friend with a math problem. See, sometimes we are so focused on being the best that we forget about things that truly matter, like developing real relationships with friends and even core values like integrity. In one of my prior classes, I found a mistake on a grade for a test, and I had not got a wrong answer. Once I told my teacher about it, my grades went down. See, so I went home and contemplated my decision. Did I make the right choice? Should I have not told the teacher? When we were kids, our innocence often prevented us from lying. But as we grow older, we are put in a sticky situation to choose between the truth or look to our benefit. And nowadays, we would rather choose to get that A and look to our benefit just to stay in this superficial competition with our peers. And any sort of guilt we had as kids is hindered from existence due to the need to be just as good as everybody else. I realized that what I did was right, because I had earned what I had worked for, which was much more rewarding for me. Truly though, all this secretivity, loneliness, and competition only puts us further away from what Charles Darwin said about the human species, that it is intertwined, interconnected, and unified in many ways. Stop worrying about what you have to lose, and think more about what you gain, what you can gain, when you give something or share, because you will always get more in return, whether it be love, kindness, or knowledge. If Einstein decided not to share his theory of relativity, or if Salk hid his polio vaccine from the world, or if Edison concealed his ingenious light bulb invention, where would the world be today? The only way we can grow is through empowering each other. Because when we share what we know, it can only make us wiser. Whenever I think of friendship, this song pops into my head.
Anoushka. Let's give everyone a round of applause. being here today. All three of our speakers shared very important, relevant, and personal messages that hopefully inspired you to be more proactive about your own life choices. Speaking of being proactive, at Diamond Bar High School, we know that this can be a very stressful, it's a very academic, rigorous environment, and sometimes it can just be overwhelming. So in addition to our wonderful counseling staff of GLCs, school psychologists, and teachers that many of you speak to, we also have a friendly, dedicated wellness consultants here, and that they are available in the Wellness Center. It is a safe, non-judgmental place that offers support. It is located across the quad in room 254, and it is open to all students Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. Sources such as support for individual students, educational classroom outreach on wellness topics, and on Thursdays, they provide the therapy docs during fourth period and lunch for much needed stress relief. Before we conclude today, I want to take this opportunity to publicly thank our distinguished panel of TED Talk judges, Mr. Rubian, Ms. Chang, Mrs. DeCambra, Senior Karen Shao, TEDx Club members Michael Chang, Jenica Sun, and Sarah Safe. Finally, this theater production would not have been possible without the support and help from Mr. Jacob Cates and our film crew, Kelsey Wu, Liana Vargas, and Kevin Saiz from Rama Cinematics. On behalf of our entire wellness team and student speakers, thank you so much for your incredible support for this event. Thank you for being here. You may be excused.